Hello drivers! As you may know, Ubisoft has closed the official servers of Driver San Francisco a few months back. In reality, the servers are still up from time to time, but this uncertainty is not great if you want to organize a game session on Driver San Francisco. Thanks for McNally, Soppy developed a custom server environment that lets you play the online multiplayer even after the end of the official support, the Alcatraz Community Server. If you remember, I already made a video tutorial on the subject a year ago, but I forgot to share useful information, so I am feeling like the tutorial is incomplete and the installation process has been a bit updated as well since then. To resume the content of this video that you can access through chapter selection, we will showcase how to install Alcatraz and get the tower icon back, then we will discuss the very important port forwarding step, and we will end with known issues and bug fixes, as well as the ways to support this community server and project. This is where I'm introducing the Alcatraz website, which acts as the main place of the installation process. The first thing to do is to create an Alcatraz account by clicking on Sign Up. Create the account with whatever name and credentials you want. This is not linked to your official Ubisoft Connect account, so you can be creative. You can change it at any time on the Alcatraz website. You can also sign in if you already have an Alcatraz account. Now that you are connected, there are two files to download. First, the download configuration by clicking on the gray button. This is a JSON file that must be placed in the Driver San Francisco directory, so the game folder. Then you can click on the blue download button that will redirect you to the Alcatraz launcher download page. Download the launcher, extract the files, and put UbiOrbit API A2Loader.dll in the game directory game folder, then run alcatrazlauncher.exe. When using the Alcatraz launcher, you need to inform the wizard where you want to install Alcatraz files and where is located your Driver San Francisco directory in case it is not the default one suggested by the tool. This method works well and is user-friendly, but when you download the files, it could be flagged as a virus by your computer. In this case, you will need to authorize it before being able to use it, as it is obviously a false flag. When Alcatraz is installed, connect to your account in the launcher and launch the game. If everything went fine, you should get the tower icon in the main menu and a welcome message to Alcatraz at the bottom of the screen. This means the installation process went well and that you should be able to play with other players, but you could still face some connectivity issues that we are going to address now. This is when we are going back to the Alcatraz website, which is holding important information and that we will indeed use for the missing part of my previous video, port forwarding. In this scenario, we are considering that you have correctly installed Alcatraz and that you have registered an account. But it does not mean that you will be able to connect to other players, because the game requires that you are using port number 3074. Alcatraz website can come handy by showing you which port the game is using on your computer. When the game is launched, go to the UDP ports tab and you can see the players currently online and the port they are using, including you. If that's 3074, you will be able to enjoy Driver San Francisco online. Note that your friends must also be on the 3074 port. If a different port is indicated in the UDP ports tab, then you need to open the 3074 port through your router device. In this case, I suggest following a dedicated tutorial on the port forwarding of your specific router brand, as it can differ from version to version. I was able to do it myself, so it should not be that hard. Now we will browse the known issues. By default, the game will launch in windowed mode. If you want full screen, you must enable it in the game options. If you can connect to other players, please check that all the players have the correct port by using the Alcatraz website when people are in game. The best way to play with people is to join the Driver Discord and play games with other players there. Another feedback we got is people thinking their save has been erased. Don't worry, everything is fine with your save, but as you created a new profile with Alcatraz, a new save has been created as well. In that case, your previous save is still in the same folder as before, in Documents, Ubisoft, Driver San Francisco, and your previous profile name. You can just copy your save to your new Alcatraz name folder and you will get back everything. Finally, you will notice that you are starting with 0 XP, and in this case that's normal and there is no way to bypass this. My advice is to simply do the tutorials that are of course easy and they will give you 4000 XP in total, so you will get a couple of levels this way. With that said, the tutorial is now a bit more complete. Knowing myself, I may still have forgotten elements but not as important as the post forwarding of last time. Anyway, all the links are in the description, the download link, the Alcatraz website, the port use tab and SOAPI support page, because yes, the custom server is not free to run and your support will be greatly appreciated by buying a coffee to SOAPI. If you still need assistance, you can ask your questions in the comment section or directly on the Driver Discord. We've played Driver San Francisco online the previous week and you can check the best moments compilation on my YouTube channel. Fender Bender made many new roads which add variety in the game modes available online. With that said, thanks to my Red Weavers, DriverDimension.com, French Contact, Neurosyn, Tekonan, YouTube, Paul Lanois, Mut, David Autosport and Denis Frontier. You can join the ReDriver Club and access exclusive rewards by clicking on the link in the description. In any case, see you soon, drivers!